Usually they say brows are like sisters, but I think one of them is adopted today. Well, good morning, my beauties, and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 42. I live in the Netherlands, hence the accent. And I haven't been sleeping very good the past few days. But my bags are looking worse than they are, at least on camera. I was changing up my lighting a little bit, but maybe I did not do so good. So yeah. I thought let's do a kind of a chatty get ready with me again, because I got some new goodies. And yeah, I want to try them out with you. Some stuff is new, but I have been using. And some stuff is new. So, I have a new lippy from Jeffree Star that arrived yesterday. Well, I actually got three new lippies. I have a lot of new lippies this month. A lot. But anyway, these were the ones that I got yesterday. This is from Jeffree Star in the color Can't Relate. I wore this in an Instagram tutorial that went live yesterday. So yeah, I really like the color though. It's really pretty. But I also got this one. And this is the color Karma. Yes, and I have seen people wear this one, and I freaking love the color. I follow Beaut Bean. If you do not follow her, go check her out because she's amazing. I will list her channel down below. But she has, I think, all the Jeffree Star lippies, and she is a really big fan of this color, and it looks so freaking pretty on her. I also saw Angie from 4F Beauty wear this one, and I thought I need it. It's so pretty, but it is kind of a difficult green color for me because I kind of don't know what kind of eye look I want to do with that. I actually want to wear that one today. I also got a lippy from Gerard Cosmetics, and it's a Hydra Matte in the color Night Rider. And I was looking for a really rich dark purple, so here it is. It's really pretty. I have one from NYX in there. What is it? Liquid Suede, but I'm not really a fan of the formula. This one was on sale, and I really wanted to try out Gerard Cosmetics. So yeah, I am going to plop on a little Dr. Paul Paul. So I was kind of looking through my collection, like, what kind of eye looks can I do? And I don't know yet. So what I'm going to do is my face first, and then the lippy, and then I can kind of build from there. If you have been with me a little bit longer, you may know that I really like the Estée Lauder Double Wear, but that is now too drying for my skin. So I got a sample of the Estee Lauder Double Wear. Is it Nude or Fresh Wear or something like that? I have it here. This one is in the color Sand, and it is really nice. I have a tiny bit left, so let's use it up today. I have a brush, yes. I also have a sponge, because I kind of like to use both. So apply it with a brush and then kind of press it in with a sponge. But I don't want the sponge to soak up too much because it's a pretty watery formula. Let me go and find a dense, firm brush. So hold on. I have a pebble brush somewhere that I actually quite like to use for this, but I freaking hate washing that one. Let's see what this Real Techniques brush does with it. So let me first dot it around my face. And I'm wearing sunscreen as usual. This is not full coverage by any means, but I am lately gravitating towards more lighter coverage. The funny thing is that I usually tend to gravitate more towards full coverage in summer. But maybe that is because in summertime my hyperpigmentation tends to show through a lot. I have hairs, and that's really annoying. So let's kind of build it up a little bit. I have a hair here. And I freaking love the normal Double Wear. It's just too dry now for me. So I thought let's try this one. And I'm actually hoping that in summer, they will get that double wear sample size of 15 milliliters again. Granted, it's only in one shade, and fortunately for me, I can kind of make that shade work. But then I only pay 8 euros for 15 milliliters of Estée Lauder double wear, which is really cheap. Oh yeah, I have a sponge here that I did wet. This is one from Primark, but this one stays really firm. So I'm kind of hoping it doesn't soak up too much product. And sometimes I also use a dry sponge for that purpose, to press the product in without it soaking up too much. I did order a few extra velvet sponges, this time from AliExpress, to try those out. And now it is more, you know, a kind of evening out my skin tone. And this is not a foundation that I can build up to full. I can kind of build it up to a light medium. But yeah, you know, on the other hand, the placement, where I place my blush is here, where I have my redness in my cheeks. Now, I didn't bring it down my neck, and as you can see, it's kind of looking okay, the color. So yeah, and again, this is the color 1W2 Sand. And the funny thing is, my undertone is neutral, but in summertime my face borders more on yellow. In wintertime it kind of pulls a little bit more towards the pinky side or the middle of the neutral side. So I can really easily use a yellowy foundation and the pinky foundation. So that's good. And I really like this formula, so I'm hoping that the Ici Paris will have a sale for Estée Lauder soon, because yeah, I have a coupon or something. So yeah, this is the foundation done. Let's move on to concealer, which is my Nabla concealer, and the color is too dark now, to be honest. But yeah, it is what I have. Oh, I could mix it a little bit, I think. Let me get my Catrice concealer as well, if I can get anything out. And let's plop it a little bit on top, because the Catrice concealer, the color is good. It's just kind of the coverage I'm missing. So let's do it like that, a little bit. But the Catrice concealer is a good concealer. And I'm kind of just lightly tapping it out a bit. I want the most coverage here, but where I have my dark circle. So I'm kind of pressing it in and then working the edges out, so that most product is there where I need it. Oh, that combination is nice though. So I really like the Nabla concealer. The only thing is, it kind of creases on me, even if I set it. So that is... But yeah, then again, you know, first world problems. But yeah, I think the coverage of the foundation is really nice. It doesn't dry out my skin. Now it's really, really cold outside, and I don't really need to powder it either. Oh, let me lock my lighting. So this is the foundation done. I got a new mascara, and why? Because I want to test it up against the Bad Girl Bang from Benefit. I got this from Alison, who lives in the UK. She sent me a goodie box a few weeks or a few months ago, actually. And this mascara was in it. I like the mascara very much, to be honest. But I am not going to pay 25 euros for a freaking mascara. I'm just not. I wear falsies a lot anyway, so I don't need it. But I like the way that this separates my lashes and is kind of clump free. I like that about this mascara. So I thought maybe I can kind of find a dupe for it. Oh, I'm itchy. I got a new mascara from Catrice. And the reason I got this is because of the wand. So let me show you. Let me open both up. So here you have the wand from the Bad Girl Bang. There. And here are the two together, so they look really similar to me. So I thought, you know what, let's try. I'm going to use both today, and one on one, you know, how it works. Okay, now this is a new mascara, so it hasn't dried down yet, and sometimes that's what mascaras need to do, dry down a little bit. But let me do my brows first real quick. I kind of need to groom them again, I think, because they're getting rambunctious on me. I do have a brow tutorial on my channel somewhere. How I do my brows, I think it's called. It's about 6 minutes long, so yeah. Why do I have pink fluff in my hair? So brows are done, and I don't know what happened. Usually they say brows are like sisters, but I think one of them is adopted today. Doesn't really matter though. What was I thinking about? Oh yeah, I also got some new brushes. Some new eye brushes from Morphe. And there are three in here that I freaking love with a passion. These are the three that I'm absolutely loving. This is the 506. Then this is the 507. And here is the E36. And they are fantastic. So let me show you. This is the shape and the size that I need for detail work. My eyes aren't too big, so I freaking love this. This is fantastic for blending out a larger surface. This one is fantastic for precise blending because of the pointy thing. And this one is, they are amazing brushes. But I also know that some people don't like Morphe. Now, I don't care one way or the other. It's just, it is really difficult. I'm going to prime my eyelids, by the way. It's really difficult to order brushes online because I can see the shape, but I cannot really see how big they are or how small. So yeah, if you have any dupes, let me know. But they need to be small. I have been looking at the e.l.f. crease brush that unfortunately I cannot find here. So that's a shame. Because that one looks to be really small as well. Okay, that's done. Eyelids primed, and I like to use a Real Techniques brush to prime my eyelids at the moment and then kind of tap it in. Okay, now let's plop that lippy on. I hope it looks okay on me. Also, so yeah. Wow. Cool. Something like that. And yes, it's wonky there. I don't care. But here's the lippy. I like it. Anyway, the foundation is setting. That means I probably don't need to powder it, which is good for me. But now I need to think about the eye look. I have here the Destiny palette from Certify that I think I can play with, especially for this mossy green. And then I also have the Tri palette by Juvia's Place. I don't know. Let's just plop something on my eyes because I don't know. So, you know what? Let's go and start with the color Hex, this one, because it's just a pretty color. So, yeah. And this is not really a tutorial. It's just me playing with makeup and talking a little bit about it. So let's just step out the creasing a bit. I thought I knew what I wanted to talk about, but I'm not sure anymore, which is handy, isn't it? I'm pressing it on because I haven't set my base yet. I kind of want to change up my beauty room thing that I have going on here. Oh, it's a nice combination though. I'm getting a backdrop. So yeah. What else? Yes, it's almost my birthday. So yeah. My birthday is the 12th of February. So I'm an Aquarius. And what I saw that on, was it Trend Mood? I think it was. I'm not sure, but I think it was, that the new BH Cosmetics Aquarius palette, which I will talk about tomorrow in my Let's Talk About Makeup, is online at the German site of BH Cosmetics. So I ordered it because it's really cute. So yeah, the one's coming, and that is, I think, about it. Okay. So I'm having a lot of fun on YouTube, which is good. I recently discovered Instagram tutorials, how I need to do that, which is really fun to do as well. So yeah, if you are not following me on Instagram, you should, because I post tutorials there now, which is fun. Okay. Let me think. I want to use the color Moss now. I'm going to go to my Morphe 506 in the color Moss. Let's plop that somewhere. And there are so many videos that I really want to do. I really like, I saw some videos about that, you know, split face, one half how you did your makeup 10 years ago and the other half how you do it now. I want to do one of those. And I am going to film, I just don't know when yet, my favorite shade in a palette, because I really like that. And when that kind of tag video or that video went around on YouTube, I didn't have 20 eyeshadow palettes. So yeah. So I want to do one of those. You guys really seem to like my blush collection. So that's good, because I like my blush collection too. So yeah, the next collection is in the works. I'm kind of building up towards my eyeshadow palette collection. That's going to be such a long video. Maybe I need to split it in two, because I also want the swatches. And oh, maybe I can combine that. So do my eyeshadow palette collection, and then together with the favorite shade. Is that an idea? That could be an idea, I think. Such a pretty green. Let's bring that down as well, close to the lash line. Okay. What do I have there? I don't know. Now what? Maybe a little bit of the color Dark Side, which is that green here, just in the outer corner. Is that a good idea? Not really, but I did it, so I need to do it here as well. I don't know what I want. A little bit of brown, maybe? Let's try the color Brew, this one. Let's get the M507, because it has more of a point, into the color Brew. Because I kind of want to darken up this part here a bit. See if that works. And I'm actually just swiping the shadow on from the outside in. Okay. A little bit of Moss. I kind of like this. Now I like it. A little bit of, let me get my E36. A little bit of Brew for the outer corner. I kind of like this makeup. I'm missing something. The color Moss on my E36. I want to intensify that green. Yes. Let's get a little bit of Brew, which is that this brown. I'm also placing that on top of my lash line. Putting the color Moss a little bit lower here in the corner. Yeah, Yes, I think that is a little bit of what I want. I'm not sure yet. Let's go back to the very first brush that I used with a tiny bit of moss to blend the edge here. And because this is a green, I need to be a little bit careful with blending because I tend to blend greens away quite easily. Yes, that's what I was afraid of. So I have here a real haired, kind of really fluffy, but somewhat smaller brush. And I'm going into the color moss. And for me personally, real hair brushes, especially with colors like this, work better because they are not prone to grab my eyeshadow base underneath, if that makes any sense. And this is one by Morphe, but it doesn't really matter. It's the shape that I'm after. Well, I think this is it, kinda. I can get the color Glass Ball, which is the silver shimmer here in this palette, this one, on a small brush. Oh, you still have purple on it. That's not handy. You know what I haven't used in a while? A sponge tip. So, let's use a sponge tip. I could have used the gold, but I kind of like this. And it's very light, a light layer that I'm putting on top. I do want a little bit of the color Tonic on the sponge tip, the other side, which is this one. Just a little bit in the center. Yes, that's better. So I'm putting it actually on top of that glass ball. A little bit more. Yeah, that's a bit better. Okay. Inner corner highlight. Let's use the color Tonic for that as well. I haven't used this palette in a while. And it is a shame because it's a really good palette. A little bit of Glass Ball. The only thing is that the shimmers are not as foiled as I personally like, but that doesn't matter too much. Oh yeah, I also had a black here. I think this is good. I think this is fun. So let me grab a brush and just kind of go over the lid here to, well, smudge it a little bit more together. Yes, okay, that is that. That is the eye look done. I do need to powder a tiny bit. So let me get my powders. I have one from Catrice. And this is the All Matte powder in color Translucent. I use this on a fluffy brush. And I'm just going to go, actually there, a little bit around the perimeter of my face. Just want a light layer, a light dusting of powder to kind of lock the foundation in its place a little bit. Like so. Then I'm going to bronze. Sure, why not? Same brush. This is the Catrice Sun Glow Matte Bronzing Powder. I do think though that I can use this as a contour, so let me do that. Let me contour. I don't know. Let me get a bronzer as well. Let me get, you're a nice one. Oh, let me use, no, you are good. Okay, so yes, I did that. So let me kind of, I don't know, buff it in a bit. I have no idea. Okay, I need a blush. What kind of blush color do I want? Revolution Sunlight Mood Lights, which is this. Says highlighter. I use it as a blush. Here. Way. Go away. Thank you. I actually just like to buff over everything I do with, well, something like this. I need to get another one of these. Next, let's do highlight. Let's get you from Catrice. This is the 3D Glow Highlighter in the color Icy Glaze. And I don't know if you can see it. Maybe if I hold it like this. This is a very light champagne-y blush. And then you have here two parts where there's a little bit of blue over it. So it's really cool toned. I think it's a really pretty one. And they have something like a glacier blush as well. That's, I think it's a baked one. I haven't tried that one yet, but it looks really pretty. But this is a really pretty blush. It is a bit glittery and a bit powdery. Granted. So usually I just place it first and then I buff it in. Let me get my lash glue ready though. Oh no, I can use you. Where did I leave you? Where did I put it? Where did I put it? I don't know. Okay, do I need a little bit more blush? I think I do. Of course I do. I think this is it. I don't feel like bronzing today. Eyeliner and mascara and falsies. So let me plop on eyeliner first. This is just my Revolution Renaissance Flick. Yes, okay. Lately I have been doing falsies before mascara, but for the purpose of this video I will not. I will put the Bad Girl Bang here. So let's do that. This is drying out though. Don't know if I can revive it. This is especially why I will not pay €25 for a mascara, because it's going to last me for maybe 2-3 months. Okay, so that's a Bad Girl Bang. Let's do Catrice on this side. It's one coat each. Let me check. I don't see a whole lot of difference, to be quite honest. And this one has a little bit of more fallout than that one, but overall I don't see a lot of difference. So yeah, I'm going to plop on some falsies, so hold on tight, I'll be right back. So am I still recording? Yes. So here is everything on, and yeah, these falsies are looking so bad up close. I really need to throw them out. But you know, it's like with a pair of jeans or maybe some shoes. They are so freaking comfortable. You need to throw them out, but they're so comfortable that you don't want to, kinda. They feel like pajama bottoms. So yeah, doesn't really matter. No one's going to look at me like that anyway. Let's go quickly over everything that is new. The lippy, let's start with the lippy. I love the color, and in here, I don't know if it will translate, but you see kind of a sparkle. I don't know if it is the packaging though. I think it is, because there's no sparkle in the lippy. I like it. It kind of does a little bit of that skipping thing, but that could be because I'm drinking coffee. And the other color that I have, this one is gorgeous as well. It's so freaking pretty, and the formula is just really, really comfortable. So yeah, the eyeshadow, I'm glad that I used it again, because in my mind, the Certify formula wasn't that great and I couldn't understand why everyone was raving about it. But now that my skill set has improved, and also the fact that the brushes I use now are a lot better than the brushes I used before, It really makes a difference. And I really like this eye look. And this is, again, something I have never done before. I played more with, well, actually a little bit of negative space, I think. I think this is really, really pretty. And this is more by my version of a neutral look, I think. But I like it. I feel pretty in it. The mascaras. This one is almost dried out, and I don't really know how if I can revive it. This feels the same as when this one was new or newish. The wands are usually not really my favorite. I remember that when I started using this one, it was felt I needed to learn to work with it, because if I wanted to put it on the base of my lashes, it kind of poked my eyes. Does that make any sense? This one does as well, but I think that's the wand that I just need to get used to. But to be quite honest, the only real difference I noticed on application was that this flaked a little bit more. But this was €3.50 or something along those lines. This one is kind of like 25. So, yeah, okay. You know what? And it is a mascara. The only thing that I want out of a mascara is that it makes my lash, that it colors my lashes, and that it doesn't flake off too much during the day. That's basically what I want out of a mascara, because I'm wearing falsies a lot of the time anyway. I do, however, love how this one separates my lashes. It doesn't give them really a lot of volume, but it does separate my lashes, as does this one. So yeah. I'm anxious to see how this one performs when it has dried down a little bit more, dried out a little bit, and then compare it to this one again. So I will plop it to the side so I can keep comparing them. What else was new? Well, the brushes are newish. And you know, I freaking love those. Mel Thompson did a video about brushes. I will link that one down below. She mainly explains the difference between synthetic and real hair brushes. I will also link Annette's video, her brush video down below, because that was the video where I ordered mine. I want to do a brush video as well, the brushes that I like to use. But yeah, the brushes are fantastic. And I have fallen back in love with this one again. This is also from Morphe. It's the 514. But it's the shape that I really like. So yeah. The foundation. Yeah, the foundation. It's so pretty. It's so comfortable. I need to powder it. Or I want to powder it down, because it is a little bit of a more luminous foundation depending on the sunscreen I wear underneath. Today I'm wearing quite a rich emollient sunscreen, one that I found I'm trying out. And then it's not that my face feels sticky, which a lot of foundations, especially the more luminous dewy ones, tend to do. This one doesn't feel sticky or tacky or yucky. It feels really nice. It looks really, really nice as well. So yeah, I am really liking this foundation, to be quite honest. And also I really love the double wear. So yeah, it's going to cost me a lot of money. But anyway, yeah. Falsies I really need to throw out. Oh, the falsies, by the way, are the Girls With Attitude swept away. Look, I have a new pair. I have a new pair here. And they're just wispy style lashes. But my God, this particular pair that I have on, I have since, well, my Primark haul. The first one, and that was in May, somewhere there, May or June. That's how long I have these falsies, and they are still going strong. They're not falling apart. They are looking kind of grungy though, but yeah, they're still going strong. What else was kind of new? This is kind of new as well, the powders from Catrice. The bronzer is a nice bronzer. I can also use it as a contour. The Catrice powder is nice as well, and the highlighter is also nice. Yeah, you know, it's quite a powdery highlighter. I think it is pretty though, but yeah, if you don't like that formula, then this one probably is not for you. The Catrice Sun Glow, yeah, I can use it Now, I don't know if I can use it in summer still, but we will see. It is a nice formula. I like it. Yeah, it is what it is. And then this one. Yeah, it's nice if I indeed put more on it than I did. Now, it definitely mattifies. It does that very, very nicely without feeling like I have a cake face. So that's good because sometimes I want the mattifying effect. Lippy, I talked about. That was it, I think. What from what was new. So yeah, that was it. It wasn't really chatty, I think. I don't know. I don't remember what I wanted to talk about. But yeah, anyway, this was it. Let me know down below if you have any of the products that I talked about today and that I tried on my face. Give me some tips and tricks if you have them. And yeah, if you like the video, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button if you haven't done so already and the bell so you will be notified of my next upload, which will be tomorrow, because tomorrow will be another Let's Talk Makeup, new makeup releases. I'm excited to chat about that. So yeah, guys, I will sign off now. I'm going to edit the video so it can go up on time, and I wish you a fantastic day, and I hope to see you tomorrow in my next one. Bye, guys.